Hi, it's Tahia here, and so in this tutorial I will show you how we can get the text from the Figma design so we can implement the multiple language features for our application. And so without further ado, let's jump right to the tutorial. Okay, so first off, you know, the multiple language and its translation depends on your client and product owner. So most of the time, if you have like a lot of language wanted to be integrated into your app, you have to keep a file like a CSV file to keep track of all the translation. But I think in this case, I will still teach you two way. For example, if you just have like the app for the local with only like two language is, and the scope of the app is pretty small, you can try this one. Okay, so the first one is kind of the more easier one. So first off, you go straight to the screen and just duplicate it into the second screen. And on this second screen here, you can just pop up and change the text for this file. Okay, so skip here, you change it to okay, so you see that first up there is missing phone here, so clearly you can go on Google to search for the phone that is missing and import into your laptop, or you just choose a different phone. Okay, so I would choose like three random phone and then replace phone. Okay, so after we remove, and then we have like the new phone. So now with this, you can just skip, you can put your translation all here if your app is small. So this one is pretty easy. It is kind of like the easiest way to do this one. Una cuenta. Yes. Okay, but this one is, and you just continue with all the screen, but this one is not good if your scope is big, or you want to have like a you want to have like a high level maintenance for your app. So we go to the second way to do this. Okay, so here comes the second way. So to do this one, you actually need have a plugin in order to export your text layer into the spreadsheet file. So to do that, you go to the top left and search for a plugin. So here, come to plugin and browse plugin in community. And you go to the search bar here to search for the copy doc plugin. Okay, so it's no result, but you click to the plugin. Here you can see that this plugin with the same name, and you install it. Okay, so because I have already installed it, and so I will go back to the screens we have. Okay, so at the screen here, I will teach you how to get all the text from all this screen. So you right click and choose plugin and click the copy doc text kit. This open a pop-up, and there are a couple of options here, but you choose the Xbox Figma text layers. So it's open another pop-up. So I will walk you through the option here to get like the easiest way to do. So first off, you export into CSV. I think this one is okay. And then you may need to order them in frame like this, so don't take this one because it's easier to keep track. But you see the default here is kind of in the wrong order, so the splash screen should be first, and finally the history screen. So you go to the filter here, I mean the order, and change it to by layer order ascending. Okay, so this, when you make sure that the first screen, which is the splash screen, is in the first row, you can hit export blue button here. Okay, and then it will open This is a full message we open, and then you just download it into your local computer. Put the screen here, so in order here you, I can put like food app translation, food app text zips, and you press save. Okay, so that is successful. Okay, so now you go back to the local computer. You open this one, translation, and then you just extract this file and you open it. Okay, so when it open, you see that we have the ID, the frame, the layer name, and the Figma text. So you want to add like another translation here, and you start to put in your translation as you wish. So here we have like login, confirm password, can be confirm la contraseña. Yeah, I'm not good at Spanish, so just pardon me, it's like my third language. And here you have like Korea, electronico. Okay, and then enter to Korea. Okay, skip. Una cuenta. Okay, so just some demo text, and you hit save. Now you go back to the Figma screen, so I will show you how we can re-import the translation into the Figma. So you can do it on another screen, but I will do it immediately on this screen. So we go back again to the plugin, also that plugin as well, but now we choose another another option. So this one is import text layer, and you drop and you open and you navigate to the file. That is the let me see. So that one is modify. Okay, this one is, okay, this one, open it. You can see that there are update text is already here for you. So next you select the translation. So you put on the translation, you can see that here are some that I have already changed, and you can tick to choose or uncheck, and finally you hit the update Figma text layer. This one take a couple of seconds, and after it's successful, it is successfully updated. You can see that the text here is already been replaced. Okay, yeah, so this is the way that you can have the product to implement this feature from the perspective of a business analyst, and I hope that it helped. And if you do find it helpful, please like, subscribe for my channel. I really appreciate it. I will put more content like this to help you with your PA role that I have learned along the way. So see you next time. Bye for now.